Hey guys, today I'll be doing a review of a pretty new to the market boxing shoe by Adams Boxing. As you can see, these are very similar, if not inspired, by Mayweather's Reebok boxing shoes, but now these are much more easier and accessible to the general public to use for their boxing or workouts. And as you can see, it's a very, very awesome looking shoe. I've worn these for about a little over 2 weeks now in the gym, just using them. So they're fairly new, still pretty clean. Haven't really beat them up too much, but still have a good idea of how they feel for myself and how they might work out for you. So as you can see, I got them in the red color scheme. I believe Carlos, who's the owner of Adams Boxing, makes them in stock colors, which are black, blue, and red. And I believe he can also do custom colors as well. He does have a Facebook if you want to check it out, Adams Boxing on Facebook. And also his website, I think, is adamsboxing.com, where you can actually purchase the shoes. The shoes are $149, so 150 bucks for a pair. And I'll explain to you whether or not I believe the shoes are worth it based on just the durability and the comfort of the shoe. So obviously the number one thing for all boxing shoes that I consider is the most important thing is that they're comfortable. If the shoes aren't comfortable, you're not going to want to wear them. You're probably going to end up returning them, or they're going to just sit in your garage and collect dust like some of my stuff has in the past. So anyhow, looking at the shoe, like I said, you can see that it's inspired by Mayweather's Reebok shoes, which were not available to the public. You can see it has kind of the red outer layer with the gray colored polyester mesh lining here. This is genuine leather, as you can see. Has very nice stitching throughout. It is a very lightweight shoe. It doesn't weigh very much. I don't actually weigh any of the gear that I review. I just think it's kind of pointless as far as weighing things go. I mean, if you really want to get exact, then you can do it yourself. But it's a very lightweight shoe. I would definitely compare it to my rival Guerrero shoes that I've reviewed in the past and I've worn. Very lightweight. And it's very nice. You can see that it does have this ankle strap support that is completely functional. So it's not just for looks. It does actually help lock your ankle in. And then you have the standard lace closure system. So you know, you just lace it like you do your regular shoes. So you start off at the top, work your way up, and it goes pretty high up. High up your legs. So it's a medium. I would call this a medium. It's not a low, it's not a high, it's not like a super high boxing boot where it almost hits your knees. This is kind of a medium, and it's not too low either. So it's a perfect height to give you the support you need around your ankle. Kind of your ankle area right up to here is good support. And then also lightweight, so you can really move around and have good mobility while you move around the ring and do your work. So at the bottom, it does have a rubber and the sole, perfect for doing slipping and also pivots. You can see it has a nice sole. The only possible downside, which I haven't ran into yet, is that maybe over time you can see that the sole is actually, I believe it's glued, but it's also stitched. Threads are stitched along this. So if you use these shoes for quite a while, eventually the threads might come loose. So I know that's something that Carlos said he wanted to address in his future versions of this shoe. You have this foam hard foam midsole, so it's good for impact, shock, for taking a shock when you're moving up and down as well. So the inside lining is a breathable polyester mesh lining, and it also does have a option where you can actually kind of fold the shoe over if you want to make it a little bit lower. So you can actually roll this over and make it a little bit lower for breathability. The shoes are made in Pakistan, has a tag right here, Adams Boxing. I wear size 10 and a half. I do have wide feet. That's probably one of the number one questions I get a lot from people are, you know, hey, what shoes are good if I have wide feet? These actually work perfectly. The reason I like these in particular is that the leather, although durable, is not super stiff or hard, as well as the polyester mesh right here. This kind of nylon polyester is very flexible, so when you put your foot in here, even if you have wide feet, typically if you have wide feet, you notice that the corner of your foot right here and right here is usually where it gets pinched. With these shoes, they're very comfortable. They have kind of a broken in feel. So I also do like that the insole has a somewhat of a mid arch. So if you have flat feet or if you have high arched feet, these work well. You can also remove, it is glued on a little bit, but if you pull on it, you can actually remove the insole and then put in your own custom insole if it bothers you that much, to give you that perfect feel. So these are a great shoe. I've used them for 2 weeks. They're great for pivoting. Comfort-wise, they're about equal to my rivals. Very comfortable. I didn't have any pressure points on my foot, especially because I have wide feet. I did get them true to size. I wore 10.5, so I got them in 10.5. I didn't have to go half size up that you do with a lot of Nikes that you have to get, where you have to get them a half size up. I've also worn Adidas in the past, and I used to have to go a half size up because they run kind of narrow, where these run pretty true to size even if you have wide feet. So it's a good mixture of both. I do like the ankle support. I definitely like the design of the shoe. They look awesome. You definitely get a lot of compliments for the shoes, the way they look, and they're very comfortable. So for the $150 price tag, I mean, I think they're a great investment. Just like a headgear, you want to protect your head, so you might spend a good amount of money on good headgear. The same thing goes for your feet. You know, if you want to, you know, have good comfort while you're training and stuff like that, or sparring, it's always good to invest in some comfortable shoes. So the other thing I like about these shoes, that true, which are true with most boxing shoes like Mizuno's and Asics and the Nikes, is that if you get Asics wrestling shoes, which you can use for boxing, I don't like those because the wrestling shoes tend to have a rolled sole. So they're kind of rounded. So you can actually twist your ankle if you're not careful when you're boxing. They're good for wrestling because you're doing mat work and you're on the floor, and they have the grip that kind of goes all the way around up to the edges. But for boxing, not so much. And I find that I've rolled my ankle a couple of times using wrestling shoes. So it's usually better to stick, if you're doing boxing, stick with boxing shoes. So definitely a great shoe, highly recommended. You know, reach out to Adams Boxing if you guys are interested. Again, adamsboxing.com. They also have Facebook. If you guys have any questions about the shoe or have anything for me, feel free to reach out. Thanks again.